Today our video is about the flushing of a borehole. As you can see in this video, now the mud box has placed over the borehole. An excavator is sealing the surrounding so the bentonite will not go out and fill inside this mud box. As you can see now, the top cover of the mud box is going to be placed on top of the mud box. So without any safety risk, we can execute the concreting works and flushing works. This top cover is consist of two openings. One opening for the pile and the next opening is for the submersible pump. After placing the mud box cover, the submersible pump is placed inside the mud box. The main purpose of the submersible pump is pumping back the overflowed bentonite into the desanding machine. There is a lid above the pile hole on the mud box top cover to retain the trimmy pipe. After placing the submersible pump, now the trimmy pipes are fixed together to prepare a longer trimmy pipe which we can insert inside the borehole up to the bottom of the borehole. As you can see in here in this video, there are two cut marks in the bottom of the trimmy pipe to allow the pass of the concrete in the bottom of the borehole. So by this, the concrete will not block inside the trimmy pipe, they will flow from these two cutouts. Now the trimmy pipe will be inserted into the borehole up to the bottom of the borehole. By closing the two lids, we can retain the trimmy pipe on top of the platform. For the purpose of connecting two trimmy pipes, there is a groove-like arrangement in both the pipes. So we have to align the two grooves and insert a cable in between the grooves to ensure the fixture of two trimmy pipes. After inserting the cable, it should be secured with the tape so it will not be entangled with other equipment. As you can see now, this trimmy pipe touches the bottom of the borehole. As this area is fully filled with sand, we are using these steel plates to bring the truck mixture closer to the borehole. Now this ramp is being placed closer to the borehole, so we can lift the backside of the truck mixture to whatever the height we required to pour concrete inside the funnel. Now all the things are ready, so we have to lay hoses to bring bentonite slurry into this borehole. So here you can see one socket arrangement of a hose which is used to bring bentonite. Here you can see one clamp is there, and inside one rubber ring is there to reduce the leakage of the bentonite. Before fixing the spigot end into this socket, it should be thoroughly cleaned. Now they have inserted the spigot end into the socket, and now there are two lever arrangements in the both side of the clamp, so we can lower it, and there is one locking arrangement, so this spigot and socket will not be dismantled. Now they are fixing a hose from the sander into the submersible pump. Then they are fixing the hose from the mission pump into the trimmy pipe, which is going all the way down to the bottom of the borehole. This is the mission pump. Here, the hoses coming from the bentonite silos are connected to the bottom of the pump, and it will be pressurized by the pump and it will be go to the top side. So this top hoses is fixed directly into the trimmy pipe. As you can remember in the previous video, I showed that hose is connecting to the trimmy pipe. This is that hose. This is the hose connected to the submersible pump. So the other end of the hose is connected to the desanding machine. As you can see, I previously showed this one. This is how they have connected this hose to the submersible pump. From the mission pump, bentonite slurry will continuously pump into the borehole. This bentonite slurry will wash inside the borehole and it will overflow to the mud box. After that, this overflowing bentonite slurry will collect inside the mud box. Then the submersible pump will pump this bentonite slurry into this desanding machine. In this desanding machine, the sand will be separated from the bentonite, and bentonite will be poured inside the bottom tank, and sand will come outside the machine. As you can see here, this is the tank we are collecting bentonite, and that side you can see one heap of sand which is coming out of the desanding machine. This is how The mission pump is pumping the bentonite inside the borehole and it is overflowing into the mud box. This process will continue up to about 1 hour, and after that we have to perform some tests to check whether this borehole is fully flushed. This is the end of this video. From the next video, I hope to explain you how to perform these tests. Therefore, please subscribe to my channel and expect more videos like this. Thank you very much.